Fox are in here, and we were right in the middle of this.
Was Mrs. Henry here with anyone last night?
Okay.
Not at first. Celine already had quite a head start.
But she attracted attention?
Certainly. A few gentlemen became very enamored with her and her stories. One guy in particular. I'm afraid someday you
leave me. Saying truth.
You know him?
No. He's been in a couple of times.
Did they leave together?
I forget.
Yes.
What the good and bad.
Around
thing.
11. If it helps, I made the guy's license plate.
Sam has taken me to Palm Springs for the weekend.
Hey, honey, what time did you get off work?
I think this could be a great help, sir. Thank you.
I don't. Yes, I got it right!
Mrs. Henry appeared to be missing a ring, torn from her finger, but not her wedding finger.
Round heels.
Celine always wore a red garnet ring on the large side. Larger than life, like Celine herself.
Did she have it a long time?
Sure. Since way back in her flying days.
Did her husband buy it for her?
No, it was before Jacob.
Doubt.
I think you know where the ring came from, and I think you're going to tell me.
Okay. I bought it years ago. I carried a torch for Celine in those days. Guess I always have. Her old man never knew about it.
Uh-huh. Knowledge of her husband.
You know the husband?
Sure I know Jacob. He was in the Corps. He met Celine on a furlough and married her when the war was finished. Put up with a load of shit.
Do you think he killed his wife?
No. No, not in my opinion.
Are you lying to me? Yep.
So if it wasn't Jacob, then you probably let her out of here with the guy who killed her. How do you feel about that?
Stole the attitude, will ya? I tried to get onto Jacob. I rang him up. Asked him to come pick her up, like usual. But he refused. As she picked some night to push him over the edge. I rang him back around 11:30, but got no answer.
11:30. I need to remember that.
Thanks, Mr. McColl. You've been a big help. One more thing. Would you have an address for Celine?
142 North Union Avenue.
Outfits.
God knows I had to send her home in enough cabs to remember that.
You want a tip? Refill my coffee next time, honey.
Let's ring the phone.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, what's the hurry? My stool was just starting to warm up nicely.
No tickets.
Doesn't look like anything.
They look like coat tickets.
Operator, give me dispatch.
I don't know what I'm asking about, but okay.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help you, officer?
How can I help, detective?
Oh, detective.
I need a registered owner on a license plate, 2BOY8899.
Yes, detective. I'll need to contact the DMV. Shall I relay the details via KGPL?
Yes.
Please.
Oh, please.
Thank you.
Whatever.
A waitress, can I have another spoon?
Why do you need another spoon? What is it with you and your spoon? Okay, fine, Rusty. I'll go around. Prick.
Die.
Henry, residence. The ACB Network presents special news from Washington. I don't think I can get through there. Whoa! Here I can.
You find the booze helps you get through a working day?
Sharpens my investigatory instincts, fellas.
A smart lawyer might use that to throw out anything you collect today.
A smart man might know it's unwise to stand between the patient and his medicine.
As long as you're not falling over, Rusty, I'll let it slide.
That's mighty kind of you, Phelps.
You know, you picked the wrong job if a healthy thirst offends you, Kurt.
We owe it to this city to do the best we can.
Gently.
We owe it to this city to do the best we can in this position. As homicide detectives, that responsibility is all the more serious.
Didn't mean to interrupt.
Always the politician.
He sounded so much more serious.
Maybe the men combing Hollywood Boulevard after the Elizabeth Short murder were more interested in sniffing out booze than the clues that would have led to her killer.
Yeah, well, if only you'd been there, choir boy. Betty Short would be alive, the Japs would have spared Pearl Harbor. Our ancestors wouldn't have tasted the forbidden fruit.
Minor syntactical error, Detective Galloway. I never claimed to be able to prevent crimes. I only suggested a proficiency in solving them. Whoa. Guess that's the drink slowing you down.
Oh my God, brother, oh brother. Worse than I could ever have imagined.
KGPL 20 Century Unit, a citizen reports a man with a gun on Grand between 4th and 5th.
He sounded so much more serious after that interruption. Whoa, people!
Just go easy, Phelps!
That wasn't my fault. Screamers, turning the siren on. We're going. Oh. And tap the brake. Oh, there's a pole there. Who put that pole there? I want to talk to the city management about removing that pole. It's in my way, preventing my epic slides. Oh, and the building too. Blue bricks, gray, dirt, tan as well. Mostly it's blue bricked and hand cement.
KGPL 20 Century Unit, the citizen reports a man with a gun. On Grand between 4th and 5th.
That sounded meaty. I think I killed that guy.
This is car 11K. Go ahead.
11K, citizen reports a man with a gun on Grand between 4th and 5th Streets. Suspect described as.
Holy smokes, he shot the guy.
Please, you've got to call for help. He doesn't look real good.
Quick, what happened?
Some punk held up my stand. This guy tried to help and got a bullet for his trouble. He got hit and hightailed it through the parking lot. Get going!
Somebody call an ambulance for that guy, please. Oh. Sorry, guys. Oh, are you kidding me? Don't worry, I still got him, Rusty. Oh, not so much now. Are you kidding me? There we go.
You come any closer, I'll pull the trigger.
Put the weapon down now!
Put the weapon down now.
You want to back off?
Oh! I shot the hostage! That was my fault. Totally my fault.
KGPL 20 Century Unit, the citizen reports a man with a gun on Grand between 4th and 5th. Any Century Unit identify?
Blah, 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 would be Robert.
Please, you've got to call for help. He doesn't look real good.
Quick, what happened?
Some punk held up my stand. This guy tried to help and got a bullet for his trouble. He got hit and hightailed it through the parking lot. Get going!
Okay. Oh, nailed him! Good!
You gotta get me closer!
Ooh.
Different man in front of the captain, guys.
You come any closer, I'll pull the trigger.
Put the weapon down now.
What the hell?
What are you waiting for, Phelps? Up and at him.
I'm going.
Oh, hold up here, Phelps.
Tuck. Not much of a climber. Huh. I scared him, and then he panicked a little bit, and then he died.
Car 11K calling KGPL. Shots fired. Suspect is down. We're code 4, but I need an ambulance on Grand between 4th and 5th Streets.
11K, roger on your ambulance. All units, be advised, the suspect is down on Grand between 4th and 5th Streets. Repeat, the suspect is down. Code 4.
Anyways.
Can you drive to this one?
Since there seems to be a street crime between every single one of these. Like, seriously. So many friggin' street crimes. Henry residence, 1104 AM. Hopefully he's home.
Try the back door. Wait here a second.
Whoa. Go, Rusty, go.
Side window's been jimmied. Looks like somebody's creeped the joint.
Jimmied. Creeped. Oh, I love the language. Look at all these freaking beer bottles.
Size 9s. Above average for a lady.
Huh. Women's 9s or men's 9s? Is this Tabasco sauce? Barbecue sauce? Let me look at the label. Los Diablos. It's barbecue sauce or something? Well, at least it was broken from the outside.
Burglar used a pry bar. Why did you kick the door in?
You think I'm gonna climb through a broken window in a $30 suit? You got another thing coming, Buster.
He's got a point. Checking outside real quick. What's that over there? It's a lawnmower.
We need to work the home address again.
What? I didn't ask you anything. Gosh, this place is a mess. Oxydol!
Nothing significant.
Is that, like, OxyClean? The early stages of OxyClean. Oxydol! Get the stain out. Wait, that's copyright. Who owns that I think that's OxyClean that owns that copyright.
Tiffany, the rest of this stuff is junk. Might explain the missing ring.
Another brush. How many brushes does she need? And again, one on the go, one...
A regular Amelia Earhart per day. The ring looks distinct.
Wow, that's an impressive ring, actually. There's still a bag here. Oops. Oop. What's this?
Seems irrelevant.
It's a hair blower. Hair dryer. Thingy. Move over. What's a digit? It's a piano. Anything on this table? Oh, yep.
Not everything here is going to be relevant.
Shut up, I'm looking at the aviator goggles. Those things are awesome. Oh, another newspaper ad. Say house fire deaths are suspicious. Family burnt to death. Husband, wife, and child.
You said I had to go back, doctor.
The fires are cathartic. They allow you to confront your past.
You said the house would be empty.
Are you taking the medication I have prescribed?
You said the house would be empty. I heard them screaming.
Circumstances were unfortunate. My colleagues had made all the necessary arrangements.
You said the house would be empty. You're killing me.
The deaths were unfortunate. But you have dealt with death before.
I want you to come to the clinic and we can deal with it.
You said the house would be empty. How can I find peace?
I hate that doctor guy. I hope I get to shoot him. Husband, wife, two young children killed. That's pretty brutal. Anything else in this? Nope. Yes. Hmm.
Hmm. Don't think this is any use to us.
Says you. What if we need to look at something that's locked? Walk the outside real quick. Okay, give me a hint.
What do you think?
Nobody home. Don't be shy, Phelps. If we want something on this broad, we're gonna have to search the place.
I've already searched the place. Fridge, what's this? If you sober up, you can find me at apartment 2.
Me and Jacob are obviously having problems. It speaks to motive.
Crime scene evidence still weighs against it being a husband. Jacob could give us something to go on.
Yeah.
When my after's drank like this, you'd be feeling the back of my hand.
Call in burglary and get technical services out here. I'll talk to the neighbors.
Don't take all day about it, Phelps. I'll get nasty when I'm thirsty.
Canvas the neighbors. But just hop that.
Let me guess. Hiding from the wife?
Homicide, badge number 564. Requesting technical services for a suspect.
You got home just at the right time, lady.
I knew it wasn't safe around here anymore.
LAPD. Are you acquainted with Celine Henry, Miss...
Horgan! Jennifer Horgan!
Whoa!
I've known Celine for more than 10 years. Our children grew up together. What's going on, officer?
Woman.
Did you see Mrs. Henry go out last night?
Well, I'm no busybody, you understand, but...
Yes.
Celine had been drinking. And she and poor, long-suffering Jacob had a terrible row. I think Jacob may have given her a black eye. He stormed out and she went back inside.
Did he come back?
No. Celine was listening to music and shouting until she left around 10 p.m. She was very drunk to have been driving. But she is not the sort of person you can stop from doing something when her dander is up. Dander. What is this about, officer? Is Celine all right?
I'm afraid Mrs. Henry has been murdered, ma'am.
Murdered? Oh, my God. I'm afraid I need to go and sit down.
Marital problems. Okay. Other neighbor? I don't like how I can't run faster than this. Sprint! Darn you, sprint! Oh, there's the door. Oh good, I'm knocking. Nobody home. Let's go across the street. There we go.
Are you drunk, mister? Or are you just cracked? I don't need this!
Hey, don't mind me.
Oh, Susie, you are so bad.
What? Okay, we're Rusty? Well, it looks like one of the neighbors ain't home. Oh, he's in the car. Could have told me you were in the car. Anyways, I'm going to call this the end of the episode. Thank you for watching. Click, comment, rate, subscribe. Fox out.